let's go port over there.
Get out and keep an eye out.
Well, there's no bottom right now, so if we get out, I'll die. Okay, there's bottom.
After everything it has taken to get to this moment, to just be on Mosman, it almost doesn't seem real, because Mosman almost seemed like a fairy tale. No, we're here.
Oh my gosh. I want a pillow made out of this.
Excuse me, spiderweb.
I'm not really sure what I'm looking for. I guess one thing is anything that could have been here when Mom and Dad were, you know, anything they might have used or might have seen even, because like a lot of these trees, you know, were still there. I found some blueberries. And have I missed this? Fresh blueberries. That was one of our favorite things to do when we lived in Alaska. And just the fact that Mom and Dad probably picked from these same bushes. Maybe it was 40 years ago, possible. Or the ancestors of these bushes is really cool. We'll find a good one. It's a little guy. Look at all of you.
I'll just get a couple more and then I'll mosey.
You know, I think one of the main things that Mom and Dad found when they were stranded on Mosman is what matters in life. And you know, I think they found their love for Alaska and their love for not even just Alaska, but the way of life that we all live, you know, and the way that we were all raised. And you know, they found that you can just be you.
I could just live in here and y'all just don't come find me. This is nice. That was a well-needed crawl through the woods.
I wish you could talk and tell me if you were here when Mom and Dad were.
Most of me wants to just spend days here, just combing through everything, because Mom and Dad spent like a year and a half here, so there's no telling. There could be things that they left behind. Mom and Dad originally got to Mosman in 1985, and I think that's just where the dream started.
I know why Mom and Dad liked this island.
But as much as I want to explore all of Mosman and, you know, just look at Mom's and Dad's past, I'm here to read the letter that Mom gave me. Mom and Dad, when they were on Mosman, they figured out what they wanted. And I'm definitely hoping that Mosman and Mom's letter is where I find answers. I've always been very sentimental. You know, if you love something, it's hard to let it go. Dad, he always understood that I was sentimental, you know, that I did want to keep an inner child. Maybe through the letter, Dad can, you know, guide me a little bit. If anybody in this world would know what Dad would want to say, it is Mom.
Dear sweet birdie babe, I know that you have a yearning inside of you, something that you are searching for because you probably feel empty within your soul or like something is missing. You know that place more now and more often than you did before because that place now seems large and empty. For the laughter of his voice. His dad Gama and Jellyhead are now merely echoes in your mind. That place in your heart, Dad's place,
It will always be there. I believe that I do have a clue that on your long and lonely days and sleepless nights may fill the hole and help you make it through it. My sweet darling butterfly, it is you.
It has brought me some clarity, for sure. Because there's a part in the letter that Mom says the way to fill the hole is me, you know? And I think she's just trying to tell me that I need to believe in myself more and that the answer isn't necessarily something that somebody else can give me, but myself.
This letter that you have carried until you have found this particular place, looking down Clarence Strait to the horizon, beautiful colors spreading across the sky, and God communicating to you. Good night, my child. Have a peaceful sleep with great love. I sure love you always more. Peace, love, and happiness.
Reading the letter that Mom wrote for me, it has a lot of personal things that honestly, it's hard for me to talk about it, but it's definitely brought some things to light. We have always lived day to day. We've never been the type of people that I'm gonna plan 5 years in the future. I'm gonna plan 2 years in the future. It's, you never know what tomorrow will bring. So you have to live in the moment. But I think one thing that Mosman has taught me is that you can't live in the past because the past is gone. Mosman is definitely where Mom and Dad started a new chapter. And you know, it is time for me to have to start that next chapter in my life.
There's so much to forage here.
Should have brought my foraging bag. After walking the path that Mom and Dad did so long ago, definitely makes me think about the decisions I have to like start a family or not. And I don't think I could do it as good as Mom and Dad do. But I don't want to miss that opportunity. I don't want that to be taken away from me. So I think I do want to have a kid. Even though it's taking a risk, and the decision to not get a hysterectomy means a somewhat dangerous one. The brown way is to follow your heart. The unknown future is scary, but it's almost scarier sometimes when you know. But ever since I was very little, I faced my fears head on, and that's just who I am.
Hey, Bird.
I'll be there in 1 second. I have to finish this. Coming to Alaska, especially Mosman, it's helped to clarify some things.
Have a seat.
But I definitely hope everybody else that has come along have found that same thing.